and it looks like Paramount MC is going to pop. And as you can see, Maricopa will defend the West goal.
And welcome to Mustangs Football. I'm Chris Lee, alongside with Jeremy Sadowski, and we're here for a special playoff edition of Mustang Sports 2003. Your America's Mustangs taking on Paramount in a big first-round playoff contest. Jeremy, tonight we have the America's Mustangs after completing a 10-0 regular season, a very impressive 10-0 regular season. Now, tonight, we're going out of the league. We're going against a team we really don't know all that much about. What can we expect to see tonight from the Mustangs and from him?
Well, Chris, the Mustangs do start their playoff run tonight against Paramount here at Waller Stadium. The Paramount team does feature a running attack, so it'll be interesting to see if this Mustang team, which has shut down basically against this season, can step up and continue that trend. As far as the Mustangs go, they're looking to start off this playoff season with a win here tonight at home, as last year the Mustangs ended off the playoffs in the finals losing to Notre Dame, who has also made it into the CIF Division III playoffs this season.
Well, as we prepare for kickoff, we look for another great offensive performance tonight by the Mustangs, especially on the running game, averaging 6.1 yards per carry and 2,667 yards combined as a team. And the kick is off. It's taken by a Paramount at about the 5-yard line, returned up to about the 28, where Paramount's running back is finally brought down. Nice return out to the 28-yard line. Paramount will start off first down and 10. Of course, Mustang's defense has been solid all season long, led by the front three of Gutierrez, Reese, and Powell. Paramount starts out on the ground. That's number 20, Greg Crittenden. Brought down nicely by the linebacking crew of the Mustangs. First Mustangs linebacking crew led by the running back combo of Kyle Dollar and Tyler Pringle, with great performances by Brian Jackson on the outside. Paramount on the run to the right. Not able to get outside as Paramount's back. Again, that was 20 Crittenden. Not able to turn that corner against the Mustangs defense. Going to bring up third down and about 6. Quarterback for Paramount. Drops back. Looks left, throws left, completes left. Out to the flat, but tackled quickly. Nice job by the Mustangs secondary. Again, there we go. There's the combo right there. Kyle Dar and Tyler Pringle combining for the tackle, bringing up a fourth down punting situation for Pillman. Mustangs set for the return. There's the snap. It's a high snap caught nicely by the punter. Kicked. Pretty nice kick out deep. Good blocking up front. Of course, it's Bruce Robinson on the return, and he's got some daylight. Finally knocked, hammered out of bounds at about the 45-yard line. But nice return by Bruce. Returned that one about 32 yards. Mustangs will take over an offense at the 42. Mustangs offense again led on the ground. Tyler Pringle, 1,631 yards on the season and 15 touchdowns on the ground. Quarterback Seidensicker drops back, throws deep, has a man wide open, but oh, cannot complete the deep pass. Number 85 for the Mustangs, of course, that's Kevin Kelly, the 6'3 junior receiver, been having a great season, 2 touchdowns and 25.4 yards per reception average. Mustangs go to the ground on the second down play and get about 2 yards. It's going to bring up 3rd down and 8 for the Mustangs. Of course, that was Tyler Pringle on the carry. Quarterback Seidensicker now on the straight drop pass. Looking right, throws right. And the pass is incomplete. We'll bring up a 4th down punting situation for the Mustangs. So two quick three and outs for both squads, and the Mustangs punt goes into the end zone and will be a touchback for Paramount. Paramount will take over first down and 10 from the 20. Jeremy, two quick drives by both teams. Do you expect nerves to be a factor in tonight's contest?
Yeah, Chris, the beginning part of this game, as both teams settle down, should be an interesting battle here as the game unfolds.
Second down and 8 now for Paramount as they kept it on the ground. Again, that Mustang front three of Powell, Gutierrez, and Reese has combined for 15 sacks from the three gentlemen on that defensive front for the Mustangs. Second down passing play, complete out to the flat, and tackled nicely by Brian Jackson and Kevin Kelly. Kevin making it up on defense there. Comes up with a big tackle, going to bring up third down. Actually got a little bit of a loss on the play. It's going to be third down and 9. Paramount now on it. Quarterback drops back, looks left, goes left, and oh, almost completes, but nice hit by the Mustangs. A late flag comes in. Let's see what that call is. Jeremy, what happened on that play?
Yeah, Chris, it appears that the Mustangs got there right in time as four Mustangs converged on the receiver. But the referee called interference, and that will be the call.
Evan Shelton on coverage on that play, but the Mustangs defense has been tough to pass against. Mustangs defensively have a combined 10 interceptions, led primarily by Britt Erdman, who has 4 picks this season. Of course, Britton, the 6'1 junior, has been pretty much involved on almost every passing play for the Mustangs if he's not getting on the tackle. Paramount now on first down and 10 after the penalty gets about 2 yards. Powell and Reese combined on that tackle. It's going to bring up second down and about 8 for Paramount. Mustangs defense, the backbone of this team. Really looking to set the pace as the Mustangs drive for CIF title. Paramount's quarterback with the pitch to the left-hand side and tackled nicely. Solo then was by Kyle Dar, then joined by the rest of the Mustangs defense. Comes up with the big second down tackle. It's going to bring it now third down and about 3 for Paramount. And there's motion all over the place, led primarily by Paramount's lineman. It's going to bring that play back about 5 yards. It's going to be third down and about 8 now for Paramount. So far, both defenses doing a nice job. Only one first down, and that was off of the Mustangs penalty. Paramount now on third down and 8. Drops back. On the third down play, they keep the ball on the ground and tackled quickly and nicely by the Mustangs defense, was Paramount's back. Mustangs had a run blitz on that play. Nice call by the Mustangs defensive coaching staff. Fourth down now and 8 for Paramount. And there's the snap for the punt. The kick is up. The kick is high and deep. And oh, Mustangs having problems on the return. Ball bounces. Hit a Mustangs return man, and Paramount recovers. First down and 10 now. Paramount after the turnover by the Mustangs. Huge early first quarter turnovers. This game right now is currently sitting at 0-0. But Paramount can look to capitalize after the turnover by the Mustangs. First down play is not going anywhere. Nice job by the Mustangs defensive front. J.D. Casulli in on that tackle. Got about 2 yards into the Paramount backfield. Finally with a 10-10 now for Paramount. Paramount goes in the air and incomplete. Britton Erdman in on the coverage. Nice play by Britton. Third down at 10 now for Paramount. And there is a timeout on the field. And with this timeout, I'd like to definitely let you fans know, stay tuned for a very special halftime show. Not only do we have, as always, yet another special edition of Fans Point of View, but we get a glimpse at a little halftime show by the Mustangs. Back to the game now, and intercepted by the Mustangs. Maricosta with the interception. Looks like that's Britton Ehrman out there. In fact, it is Britton coming up with the big interception and return. Jeremy, what did Britton do on that play?
Well, Chris, like all season, he seems to be everywhere where the ball is on defense. As he gets another interception, he returns it down the sideline into the Pirate territory.
Britton Ehrman coming up big as always with his fifth pick of the season. Mustangs will take over now in good field position right at the 50-yard line, first down and 10. Quarterback Brian Seinsticker, under center with the pitch. Pitch out to Pringle. Pringle turns up the right-hand side of the field, and he's got a hole, makes a couple of nice moves. Finally brought down at the 27-yard line. Nice run by the running back Pringle. First down and 10 Mustangs. Quarterback Seinsticker now. Drops back, hands off to Pringle again. Cuts up field and is tackled finally at the just about the 20-yard line. It's going to be close to another first down. Looks like maybe just shy. He is just shy. Second down and one for the Mustangs. Quarterback Seinsticker now with the handoff this time to his big fullback, Kyle Darr, who spins upfield and gets enough for the first down. Nice 4-yard run by Darr. First down and 10 Mustangs. Chris Darr averaging 7.2 yards per carry on the ground for the Mustangs. Very well balanced running attack. This time it's Pringle on the left-hand side, cuts upfield and is brought down at just about the 10-yard line. About a 7-yard run, it's going to be second down and short for the Mustangs. We got a flag on the field, though, and it's an illegal shift against the Mustangs. Mustangs will have to repeat first down now after the penalty. Mustangs set up now on offense. First down and about 15 now. And the handoff goes to Tyler Pringle running right up the middle and is tackled after about a 5-yard run. It's going to bring up second down and 10 for the Mustangs. Ball spotted at the 17-yard line as the Mustangs are now in red zone. And Seinsticker dropping back, has a man wide open in the end zone, and it's a touchdown Mustangs. Big number 88, Brian Jackson, the tight end, snuck down the middle of the field and was wide open. Great job on the play action pass. Touchdown Mustangs. Mustangs hit the scoreboard first. Joe Houston setting up now for the point after attempt. Mustangs first one is to jump on the scoreboard tied here in the first quarter. Mustangs leading this contest 6-0, trying to make that 7 as Joe Houston gets his kick. It's up, it's high, it's deep, it's straight, it's good. 7-0 Mustangs. Jeremy, what the Mustangs do on that scoring drive?
Well, Chris, the Mustangs established the run with running backs Tyler Pringle and Kyle Darr, and then they used the play action out the tight end, number 88 of the season, Brian Jackson, to get wide open down the middle and catch the touchdown.
Of course, that's Brian's second touchdown of the season, and he averages a whopping 15.7 yards per carry. That's certainly going to help his season totals as the Mustangs jump on the scoreboard first. Permit now on the return gets to about the 22-yard line. It's going to bring up first down and 10 for Paramount. Come out in a shit formation. hand off to the running back on the right-hand side, and he gets nowhere. Gets about 1 yard on the play. It's going to bring up second down and about 9 for Paramount. This thing's defense so far responding well. Paramount on offense now, second down play. Quarterback drops back. He's looking left and scrambling left and gets hammered. Ball comes loose. And the Mustangs recover. Jeremy, what happened?
Like we've seen all season, Chris. Big number 49, Justin Reese, put a punishing hit, forcing the fumble. Turnover Mustangs. Great job by the big Mustang defensive lineman, number 49, Justin Reese.
Mustangs will take over now. First down and 10 at the 27-yard line. Nice job by the Mustangs defense coming up with yet another big play. Sign sticker now in shotgun formation. Looks right, throws right, and trips, and completes right. Nice job. Nice spin move out there by number 84, Robert Jackson. The 6'2 senior got a nice gain on the play. It's going to be just short of the first down, about 3 yards short. Nice 7-yard reception, though, on the opening drive of this early on here and late in the first quarter for the Mustangs. Mustangs trying to add to that scoreboard total. Second down play, keep it on the ground. It's Kyle Darr for about 4 yards. It should be enough for the first down. Let's double check the spot on the ball. And it is enough for the first down. First down and 10, Mustangs. And that's the end of the first quarter. With one quarter underway, the Mustangs lead this contest 7-0. As we're here, first round game in beautiful Waller Stadium, first round CIF playoffs, and the Mustangs leading this contest 7-0. First down at 10 now, Mustangs. Evan Kelly in motion. There's a handoff to big fullback Gar, who gets about about 3 yards on the play. Second down and 7 for the Mustangs. Ball spotted at the 13-yard line. And a timeout called on the field by the Mustangs. Quarterback side sticker wanted to make sure he had the right play in there. Calls the timeout. Again, fans, remember, stay tuned to a very special halftime show. Not only do we have, as always, fans' point of view, but we have a special show. The Mustangs singing dancing squad will be out performing a very special halftime show, and we're going to bring you clips from that show at halftime. Third down and about 3 now for the Mustangs. Mustangs in a split back formation. Receiver in motion is Kevin Kelly, and there's the snap. There's option play right. Quarterback Brian Seinsicker keeps it and gets to about the 2-yard line. Almost got in for the touchdown. Nice job by Seinsicker on the option play right to not pitch it and keep it himself. Good yardage, first down and goal. And there's the handoff, first back through. And that's Big Mata. Oh, leap for it, but just not able to get into the end zone. Second down play, though. Nice job by Mata. He loves to go high in the air. We've seen him do it over the top many times this season. Second down and goal for the Mustangs. And this time it's Tyler Pringle going over the top, and he does get in the end zone. Touchdown, Mustangs.
Again, great job by the Mustang lineman getting penetration, allowing the running backs the space to get over the top and get that ball in the end zone. Touchdown, Mustang.
And Joe Houston on the point after attempt. Kick is up, down the middle, and good. Make that scoreboard total 14-0 now here in the second quarter. Your Mustangs are sitting pretty early on in this first round CIF playoff contest. Mustangs now setting up for the kickoff. Leading this contest 14-0. Kickoff team is set, and Joe Houston with the kick. Nice kick taken about the 7-yard line by Paramount. Returned down the middle and tackled nicely by the Mustangs unit, special teams unit. Paramount only able to get to the 21-yard line. First down and 10, Paramount here in the second quarter on the 21. Paramount now on first down and 10. Here's the snap and the handoff to the first back through. And that was Greg Crittenden, not able to get anything. Great job by the Mustangs. Front three so far in this contest has not been giving up anything on the ground to Paramount. Second down and 8 now. And Paramount keeps the ball on the ground again. This time tackled in the secondary. Looks like Britt Nerman in on that tackle. Going to bring up third down now and about 4. Mustangs showing blitz. And they bring it in. Oh! Big play, interception. That's Anthony Espinoza in for the touchdown.
Great job here by the Mustangs as number 88 Brian Jackson gets some pressure. Looks like he might have even touched the ball a little bit, deflecting it slightly. And then Anthony Espinoza with the concentration to pull it in and return it for the touchdown. Another great job by the Mustang defensive backs as the Mustangs now lead 20-0 pending Joe Houston's extra point.
First, that's Anthony's second interception, and boy, is that a timely one as he gets the pick and gets into the end zone. Touchdown, Mustangs. Joe Houston now set up for the point after attempt. There's a snap and there's the kick. The kick is high, the kick is straight, and the kick is good. Make that scoreboard 21-0 Mustangs with 8 minutes and 13 seconds left to go here in the second quarter. And the Mustangs are rolling in this contest. Very impressive performance so far here in the first half by the Mustangs. Really going to force Paramount out of their game and force them in the air now.
Yeah, Chris, so far the Mustangs defense is leading Paramount 6-0 within this game as we see the kickoff go.
And that's returned by Paramount. Number 37, David Elizondo, finally brought down. Nice job by the Mustangs. That's number 86, Evan Chelton, in on that tackle. Even the Mustang special team is doing a great job out there. Paramount now taking over with the ball at the 12-yard line. And there's a pitch out to Junior Taveo, who was tackled nicely by the Mustangs defensive group after a decent game. It's going to bring up second and end about 1 for Paramount.
Yeah, Chris, by the way, the special teams for the Mustangs are leading the Paramount Pirates 3-0.
And Paramount now trying to go on the right-hand side, but nothing doing out there. Britt Nerman stepping up with a big hit. First down and 10 for Paramount. Penalty was on the Mustangs. First down and 10 now. And there is the pinch. That's again Junior Caveo. And gets nowhere on the first down carry. It's going to bring up second down and about 9 for Paramount. Again, that Mustangs defense is solid. This is And Paramount keeps it on the ground, trying to run up the middle, but nowhere to go is Paramount's running back. That time it was, again, number five, Junior Taveo, the 5'11 junior, was looking for room to run, but could not find it. Mustangs are coming with some big pressure on the offensive line for Paramount. Not giving up any holes and not letting the offensive line push them around. Mustangs showing blitz now. They come with it, but Paramount keeps it on the ground and gets about 1 yard, which is not anywhere near enough for the first down, as both number 20, Tyler Pringle, and 31, Britt Nerman, were in on that tackle. Fourth down, punting situation now for Paramount. Mustangs looking to see if they can add a little bit more with time running out in the second quarter, just over 5 minutes to go in the second. Paramount now with the punt. It's a high punt, it's a deep punt, and it's fumble. That's the quarterback, number seven, Brian Seinsticker, on the back there to take that punt, but he fumbled the punt. Paramount takes over. That's twice this contest the Mustangs have fumbled or misplayed a punt return. Paramount will take over, first down and 10. Definitely not the situation the Mustangs defense was looking to get into. Paramount now on first down play, broken play. There's a flag on the play that hit the quarterback in the head as he was making his dive. Tackle nicely by Mata Powell, but after a 3 yard scramble, but let's see what that call is. Holding against Paramount. First down repeated, but first down now and about 20. Paramount on the drop back, throwing deep. Double coverage out there and intercepted. Third interception for the Mustangs defense by Kevin Kelly.
Yeah, Chris, it almost looked like Kevin Kelly was the intended receiver there, running an out pattern as he made a great catch, keeping his feet in bounds. Like in college, you only need 1 foot in bounds to make a reception legal in high school. Kevin Kelly had both of them.
Double coverage on that play by Kevin Kelly and Britt Nertman. Kevin comes up with the interception. First down and 10 Mustangs. Mustangs on the play action. And complete to Brian Jackson. Big play down the right-hand side. Again, nice job on play action by the Mustangs. Brian Seinsticker.
Yeah, Chris, it appears that the linebacker from Paramount is something. Brian Jackson bites on that play action play just about every time as the Mustangs find Brian Jackson again for another first down.
First down and 10 now for the Mustangs at the 50-yard line. Quarterback Seinsticker dropping back. He's looking left, he's throwing left, and completes left. That's number 15, Anthony Espinoza. Already with one touchdown on the interception return tonight. This time comes up with a big catch on the sideline for the Mustangs. First down play as the Mustangs got about 12 yards on the catch. Nice pass reception by Anthony Espinoza. First down and 10, Mustangs. Quarterback Seinsticker pitches out to number 20, Tyler Pringle, who's tripped up. But not until after he gets about 6 yards on the play. It's going to bring up second down and short for the Mustangs. Second down and three, we'll call it. Split back formation. Man in motion, and Seinsticker drops back. He's looking left, throwing left, and completes in the middle. Nice job out there. That was the man who was in motion, Kevin Kelly. Comes up with a nice reception. Should be enough for the first down. And it is. First down and 10, Mustangs. Ball at the 20-yard line. Mustangs trying to add to this already 21-0 score. Seinsticker on the draw play. This time hands off to number 20, Tyler Pringle, who fumbles the ball. But he looks like he was able to recover. Thank goodness for the Mustangs. Still Mustangs ball. Second down now and about 12. 2 yards lost on the fumble. Quarterback Seinsticker having an excellent game. Drops back, throws right, and throws just short. going for Kevin Kelly on the crossing pattern, but through just behind his intended target, incomplete pass, third down now and 12 for the Mustangs. Quarterback sign sicker now. Play action fake, he's looking left, he's throwing left, he's throwing deep left, and oh, had a man wide open. That was number 22, the running back, Kyle Darva. Kyle just couldn't come up with the ball. Incomplete. Fourth down play now for the Mustangs. Mustangs going to go for the field goal attempt. Joe Houston set up. Ball spotted at the 29. It's going to be a 39-yard attempt. The kick is up. The kick is high enough, but just to the right-hand side of the goalpost. Field goal attempt is not good. Paramount will take over now on downs at the 29-yard line. Mustangs still leading this contest 21-0 here in the second quarter. Paramount keeps it on the ground on the first down play. Gets about 3 yards on the play. It's going to bring up second down and 7 for Paramount. That was Junior Tavayo with the carry. Second down and 7 play now as we're getting closer and closer to the end of this second quarter. Paramount now on the ground again. That time it was Clifford Ross with the carry. 5'10 sophomore got about 4 yards on the play. It's going to bring up third down and 4 now for Paramount. Again, fans, stay tuned for a special halftime show. Paramount on the third down play, and oh, we got bodies moving all over the place and flags flying. Looks like it's going to be a motion penalty against Paramount. Let's get the word from the official. And it is illegal motion against Paramount. Bring them back 5 more yards. It's going to bring up now third down and about 9 for Paramount. Paramount not helping themselves out by any means tonight. Mustangs now on defense. Oh, a couple missed tackles. Paramount's back, able to break a couple, but not able to break enough as Clifford Ross only got about, I'd say, 5 yards on the play. It's going to bring up fourth down, punting situation. And in fact, Clifford Ross limps off the field and got hurt on the play. So not only did he not get the first down, he got hurt. Paramount now forced to punt on fourth down. And it's a high punt, it's a deep punt, and oh my gosh, the Mustangs almost turned that one over again on the punt team. Special teams punt return having some problems tonight. That time it was Bruce Robinson's turn.
Yeah, Chris, that's the third Mustang punt returner to have a fumble. Luckily, the Mustangs have only lost one as they take over first down and 10.
First down and 10 Mustangs as we're near the end of the second quarter. Play action pass. Sidesticker rolling left, throwing left, and completes left. Nice job again. That's number 88, Brian Jackson. His third reception tonight. Already with one touchdown. Mustangs going, of course, in the hurry-up offense and towards the end of the second quarter. Nice job by the tight end, Jackson. So far this contest, 3 big receptions. Sign Seeker drops back and incomplete pass. Had Jackson again in the middle, but that ball was tipped at the line of scrimmage. Nice job by Paramount's defensive front. It's going to bring up second and end 10 now. 36 seconds remaining to go here in the second quarter. Your Mustangs lead this contest 21-0. Sign Seeker hands off this time to Tyler Pringle, who squirts downfield about a 17-yard carry. Mustangs in a hurry at offense. Better hurry up and get down there. As they are driving, there's only 13 seconds left to go in this half. Mustangs trying to see if they can get anything else to go here. This time it's play action. Sight super rolling right, throwing right, completes right to Kyle Dar. Tries to get out of bounds. And looks like he was able to get out of bounds. Nice job by Kyle. 5 yards on the reception. Only about 18 seconds left to go now here in the second quarter with your Mustangs leading 21-0, but trying to add to that total late in the second quarter. Quarterback Seidensicker drops back. Looks left, throws left, and completes left down to the 2 yard line. Big reception. Nice job, Mustangs. That time it was his other running back, Tyler Pringle. Big receptions. Mustangs hurrying up to get down there. First and goal from the 2 and see if they can get set up in time. Of course, the clock does stop out with the chains moving. Seidensicker gets there in time, drops back, looks left, throws left. It's close, and it's a touchdown! Anthony Espinoza with the second touchdown of this evening. The 5'10 senior having a big night. Great job on the quick corner pattern by the Mustangs. Touchdown, Mustangs.
Chris, I thought the Mustangs were going to try and stop the clock by spiking the ball late down there with that first down catch by Tyler Pringle. But they decided to go for it, and they got the touchdown there with 2 seconds left here in the first half as we see Joe Houston make the extra point, making it 28-0 Mustangs here in the first round CIF Division III playoff matchup.
28-0 is the score. 2 seconds remain. That should pretty much wear off on the ensuing kickoff as we're prepared for the Mustangs kickoff. That should just about lead us into halftime. Great job on the hurry up offense by the Mustangs to get one last touchdown in before the half. And there is the kick. And that's the end of the first half. Paramount tried to down the ball on the play, but was not able to. Mustangs will go into halftime, leading this contest 28-0. Great job by the Mustangs offense and defense, scoring one touchdown on defense and 3 on offense, mostly in the air, and 1 rushing touchdown. Great job by the Mustangs. Stay tuned, fans, for a special Fans Point of View.
Jerry Petrosik, I'm with Fans Point of View, and I'm with Terry Mulholland, and Mike Zucker in the Valley would like to ask you, what is your favorite stadium?
Well, American League, I'd say Yankee Stadium. I was fortunate to play there in 94 with the Yankees, and just the tradition, and the whole lore about the Yankees. And then National League, I'd probably say Wrigley Field. Played there as a Cub, and just really enjoyed the day games.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
welcome back to the second half of action as your Mustangs are leading this special playoff round, first round playoff action against Paramount 28-0. After some near miscues on the Mustang special teams, they've overcome that by some great offense and great defense, big plays on both sides tonight. Jeremy, what did you think about that exciting first half of action?
Well, the Mustangs were able to utilize the play action pass really effectively in that first half. As you know well, that they set up that power running attack featuring Kyle Darn and Tyler Pringle. And then they were able to use the play action to get the tight end, big seam, captain, 88, Brian Jackson, involved. Great job by the Mustangs distributing the ball. And we'll see if the Mustangs can continue their dominance over these Paramount Pirates.
And as we know, very traditionally in sports, especially come playoff time, it's the little guys that come out and make the biggest plays, the ones that you really haven't heard all that much about all season long. And it's those guys that really make the special plays come playoffs. Tonight, so far, that guy's been Anthony Espinosa, coming up with a big interception return for the touchdown, as well as a regular reception for a touchdown. Two touchdowns tonight from Anthony Espinosa. Great job by Anthony leading this Mustangs here in the first half. And the second half begins with Charles Wolfgram on the return. I'm sorry, not Nick Woodward on the return. Gets about out to the 26-yard line. Nice job on the return by Charles, by Nick Woodward. First down and 10, Mustangs at the 26. Quarterback sign sticker on the pitch play. Misdirection pitch play to Tyler Pringle. Big hole on the left-hand side. Spins, breaks more tackles. Keeps going, and oh boy, great run on first down. Tyler Pringle gets all the way down to the 36.
Yeah, because I don't know what the referee was seeing in this play when he said that there was holding, as we see a good block there by number 85, Kevin Kelly. It didn't look like a hold, it just looked like a really good block, but not according to the officials.
Unfortunate outcome at the holding call takes away what would have been a 39-yard carry by Tyler Pringle. Instead, it comes back. It's repeat first down now for the Mustangs. Ball spotted back now at the 30-yard line. As the hold was downfield, it brings up a first down and 7 situation. Mustangs with Kyle Darr right up the middle, get close to the first down. Looks like he was just shy, however. It's going to bring up second down and about 2. Kevin Kelly in motion. Split back formation. And we have option right. Quarterback Sutton decides to keep it. Tries to work forward and looks like he's going to be just shy. In fact, he is just shy of the first down. Third down and short for the Mustangs. Third down and less than a yard. See what the Mustangs do. Kevin Kelly in motion. Again, split back formation. This time the handoff goes to Kyle Darr. I'm sorry, Tyler Pringle, who bust a tackle and is finally brought down after an 8-yard carry. Nice job by Tyler Pringle. First down and 10, Mustangs. Ball spotted at the 45-yard line. First down and 10, Mustangs. 3 receiver set. Quarterback side and sinker drops back. Looking left, couldn't find anyone. Scrambles, under pressure now. And finally sacked. Big loss on the play. It's going to be about a 15-yard loss. Second down now and 15 for the Mustangs. Sinsicker just couldn't find anyone open downfield and faced heavy pressure. Mustangs now on the pitch play left. And tackled after about a 4-yard gain was number 24, Nick Woodward. It's going to bring up third down now and about 10 as the Mustangs got up to just about the original line of scrimmage. Third down play coming up now for the Mustangs as they lead this contest 28-0 here in the third quarter. Quarterback Seinsicker on the QB keeper, scrambles forward, and he gets enough for the first down and then some. He's still going, finally brought down about the 25-yard line. Great job on the scramble play by Brian Seinsicker.
Yeah, Chris, it appears like that was a designed play. The quarterback draws. Quarterback Seinsicker pulled down the block pretty quick there, seeing the open lane and getting a great running gain there by the Mustang quarterback number 7, Brian Seinsicker.
Of course, it was a third down and long situation, so everyone on Paramount was dropping back, expecting a deep pass. Brian, with a nice job using his speed, got the first down. Brian now in the air, this time hits his big tight end again, his fourth reception tonight. Number 88, Brian Jackson, big time catch down the middle of the field. That's going to bring up first down and goal for the Mustangs. As we see again, the Mustangs on the play action fake, hitting the big tight end to bring up first down and goal now from the 4. And play action play again, and there it is again. Touchdown Mustangs. Quarterback Brian Seinsicker again to his big tight end, Brian Jackson. Joe Houston now setting up for the point after attempt. And there's the snap, and there's the kick. The kick is high, the kick is deep, the kick is good, and your Mustangs lead this contest now 35-0 here in the third quarter.
Chris, this Mustang team has been impressive coming out so far in this first round of Division III playoff action by dominating the Paramount Pirates 35-0 here in the third quarter.
Of course, but that reception, his fifth of the evening, Brian Jackson not only gets his second touchdown of the night, but goes over 100 yards receiving. Great game by the tight end. The senior stepping up here in the first round playoffs, Brian Jackson. Paramount now will take over first down and 10 after a short return. Ball spotted at the 26-yard line for Paramount. There's a running play up the middle. That's running back Greg Crittenden. Of course, Paramount not able to get much of anything on the ground so far this contest. Nice job by the Mustangs defense to really stop the powerful Paramount rushing attack. Second down and 7 for Paramount now. Mustangs showing blitz. Brian Jackson stepping up, and there is the blitz. But the QB decided to keep it himself. Squirted forward for about 6 yards. Going to be just shy of the first down. Third down and 1 for Paramount. I think the quarterback saw the blitz coming on that play. Thought he could get anything he could. Just kept it himself and ran straight upfield for about 4 yards. Keeps it himself again this time, trying to get the first down. Let's see, let's double check the spot on the ball. He was close. He only had about 1 yard to go. I don't know if he got it. Let's check the call from the officials. It looks like he was short. He was short, in fact. He's still fourth and inches. Paramount now almost forced to go for it at this point. Let's see what they do on this play. Two straight quarterback keepers. Let's see what they do now on fourth down and inches. Oh no, in fact, they're going to punt the ball. Better call. And oh, Mustangs come up with the big block. Anthony Espinoza with this third huge play of this contest. Coming up with the block. And number 50, bringing it here, is recovered.
Yeah, Chris, as we see Anthony Espinoza coming off the left-hand side and just getting a hand on the ball. Another great play by the senior defensive back as well as wide receiver and all-around special team player as he has made a key play on offense, defense, and now special teams.
Mustangs take over now, first down and 10, with the ball at the 30-yard line. Quarterback sign sticker leading the Mustangs offense with the handoff. Oh, with the big hole up the middle. Nice job by the Mustangs. That's about 16 yards on that carry by number 30, Charles Wolfram, the 5'9 sophomore. Of course, we're only in the third quarter, but expect to see some guys like Charles Wolfram get into this contest. It's a great situation for these younger players to see CIF playoff competition without having to worry about hurting their team, as the Mustangs lead this contest 35-0. As we saw that time, number 24, Nick Woodward with the carry. Nick getting the ball down to the 4-yard line. First down and goal now for the Mustangs. And the Mustangs keep it on the ground again. Again, it's Nick Woodward. He's close. It looks like he may be in. Oh, stopped just short. I thought he had it, but he stopped just short of the goal line. Second down and goal from just inside the one. Second down and inches. It's the QB keeper this time, and Brian Seinsicker is in for the touchdown. Touchdown, Mustang. Nice job by the Mustangs offense to come in the field after the interception. I'm sorry, after the blocked punt attempt to convert that turnover. Great job, Mustangs. 42-0 now. This contest stands with the Mustangs of this game well in control. Jeremy, what do you think about that drive?
Chris is getting set up by the incredible play by number 15, Anthony Espinosa, as he contributes again with the block punt. And then number 50, the senior captain, Brendan Gutierrez, with the recovery, setting the Mustangs in a great field goal position, in field position rather, and the Mustangs convert with the touchdown.
First down and 10 now, Paramount. As this game is well in the Mustangs' hands, 42-0. Paramount keeps it on the ground. Paramount's back is able to fight forward for about 6 yards. Gonna bring up second down and about four now for Paramount. Paramount now on the second down and four play. Keep it on the ground again. It's number 5, Junior Cabello, who was tackled nicely by the Mustangs, but not until he gets enough for the first down. First down and 10 now, Paramount. Jeremy, this is not the only playoff game going on tonight. What else is going out there in the CIF playoffs?
Well, Chris, in Division 3, the next opponent for the Mustangs will be the winner of Chaminade and Arcadia. Currently, late in the fourth quarter, it's Chaminade 56, Arcadia 32. Also in the fourth quarter, Linwood 38, Peninsula 26. We have a final here. Sherman Oaks, Notre Dame 35, Lancaster 27. Also here late in the third quarter, it's Palmdale 26, St. Francis 0. Another opponent of the Mustangs earlier this season, Warren, snuck out with a victory tonight 15-14. Beverly Hills, last week's opponent for the Mustangs, lost 21-44. As well as St. Paul is leading late in the fourth, 46-17. Also, I'd like to give congratulations out to the St. Genevieve Valiants as they made it to the playoffs and notched a win tonight over Lucerne Valley.
And back to live action. Paramount carries the ball out to about the 50-yard line. It's going to bring up second down now and about six. As we're coming towards the end, and there is the end of the third quarter. Your Mustangs with this game well in hand, 42-0. An exciting contest so far this evening. But the Mustangs taking this game away from Paramount early on and continue to add to that total. Jeremy, what do you think about this contest through the first three quarters?
Another dominating attack by the Mustangs. I would say have just completely shut down the Paramount Pirates, getting ready for next week's game against Chaminade, a very high potent passing attack. So I was able to talk to one of the Chaminade assistant coaches scouting tonight's game halftime, and he was mentioning that they feature a very potent passing attack, similar to Taft's passing attack. So it'll be interesting to see what will happen as the Mustangs tune up in this final fourth quarter of the first round game, get ready for next week's competition.
Fourth down play now for Paramount. Force the punt, and Mustangs will return the punt. That's 31, Britt Nerman, this time back on punt return, and he gets a nice return. Great job by Britt Nerman on the right-hand side. Finally brought down, gets about 37 yards on the return. Nice job by Britt Nerman with the big interception earlier in this contest. Now sets the Mustangs offense up with good field position.
Yeah, Chris, the only blemish for the Mustangs tonight were those three fumbles on the punt returns by the three different Mustang punters, or punt returners. As we see it, another fumble by the Mustangs, and that one's recovered by Paramount.
That was number 30, Charles Wolfram, with the cough up that time. Let's see what the Paramount can do. Well, of course, at this point of the contest, with the score of 42 to nothing, Mustang's not really too worried at this point about any turnovers. Of course, more than anything, they just like to run the rest of this clock out. Hopefully get some rest for some of their key players and get ready for next week's contest. Paramount on first down gets about 3 yards on the run. Can bring up second down now and about 7 yards. Ball spotted exactly at the 50-yard line. Paramount with the handoff and nothing doing on that play. Great job by the front group by the Mustangs. That was number 58, David Cordova. And on that tackle, another sophomore. Of course, Mustangs able to add some sophomores up, bring them up for the playoffs. Great opportunity for them to see some playoff excitement action. Cordova making the most of his opportunity, comes up with a big tackle on that play, and almost comes up with another one, but the Mustangs defensive group all over that run up the middle. About 2 yards gained on the play. It's going to bring up a fourth down situation. Let's see if Paramount punts it or decides to run a play. Looks like they're going to punt. Mata Tau coming in off the field. Nice job by Mata all season long for the Mustangs. On both offense and defense, of course, Mata as a running back with four yards per carry average and 5 touchdowns. And then on defense, Mata, one of the team leaders in tackles with 49 tackles, also had 2 sacks on the season and forced 2 turnovers. Paramount now with the punt. It's a high kick, it's a deep kick, and it's fumbled by the Mustangs again, Bruce Robinson. But this time Bruce able to recover his fumble and still gets about 7 yards on the return. Nice job by Bruce to still gain control of that fumble and still get positive yardage for the Mustangs. Now it's the Mustangs on offense on the big run play. That was number 24, Nick Woodward, on the right-hand side. And in at quarterback, as we see a flag on the play, is number 8, Kevin Romero, the 5'10 sophomore, seeing some playoff action. Seeing a lot of the sophomores getting some time now. penalty flag against the Mustangs. Going to bring up now first down and about 20. This is a holding call against the Mustangs. And again, it's quarterback Romero to number 24, Nick Woodward. Nick, the junior backup tailback, has done a great job for the Mustangs all season long, getting some key carries here late in the contest. Mustangs on the sweep play. Big hole on the right-hand side. Nick doing a great job breaking some tackles and dragging some people for an extra 5 yards. Big play on the ground. What was originally a first down and 20, all of a sudden is a third down and about 2. Nice job by the Mustangs ground attack. Quarterback Romero with double receiver set, hands off to Charles Wolfram this time, who breaks some more tackles and is still going deep down the right-hand side. Nice job, finally tackled about the 15-yard line. Great job by Charles Wolfram.
Yeah, Chris, it appears that Charles was a little shaken up on the play on the tackle, as we see him getting great yardage, making some nice moves and breaking some tackles and getting the ball all the way down to the Mustang, or to the Paramount 15-yard line before he's tackled out of bounds.
And great lead blocking on the play, including number 71, Andy Oldenfield. Great job by the Mustangs offensive line all season long, as we see Charles on his own power able to get to the sidelines. He does look a little shaken up. Hopefully he'll be fine for next week. Mustangs now on first down and 10. Number 4, Ken Rule in motion. And the handoff goes to Nick Woodward, who fights his way down to the 5-yard line. Another strong rushing attack shown by the Mustangs. Here we are in the fourth quarter. Mustangs, of course, at this point leading 42-0, just looking to kill the rest of the time. But meantime, the Mustangs backups have gotten this down to first and goal from the 6. Flag down on the play. That one may have been against the defense, but let's check the call from the official. Quarterback Kevin Romero taking the snaps now. It was against the defense of Paramount. First and goal now from the 3. And into the end zone are the Mustangs. Touchdown, Maricosta. That time it was number 25, John Valencia, with the touchdown. Run right up the middle. The 5'11 junior with a nice run. Touchdown, Maricosta. First, that's John's first touchdown of the season. Congratulations to John Valencia. It's a good time to pick up your first touchdown here in the playoffs. Joe Houston's point after attempt is good, and the Mustangs lead this contest 49-0 here late in the fourth quarter. Jeremy, a nice drive by the Mustangs backups. Could we see that we normally wouldn't see on that drive?
Well, Chris, finishing off the drive and scoring his first touchdown for the varsity was number 25, John Valencia. It's a key member of the JV team this year.
Mustangs now on the kickoff. Taken about 1 yard deep into the end zone, and it's a touchback. It's going to be first down and 10 from the 20-yard line for Paramount. Looks like the Mustangs cheer squad with the score 49-0, getting a lot of push-up workouts this contest, that's for sure. And number 20 for Paramount, Greg Crittenden, with the carry, gets about 6 yards on the play. It's going to be up second down and about 4. As we see number 30, Charles Wolfram, walking on the sideline, still a little of a limp, but walking much healthier. Nice to see Charles up and about. Looks like he should be ready for the next contest. First, Charles, not only a running back, as the position he had when he got hurt on the play, but also a key linebacker for the Mustangs. As as we see the ball boys for the Mustangs getting all pumped up, getting ready for next week. Chris Charles with 23 tackles on the season, two of which for losses, and recovered one fumble. Second down and one for Paramount. Mustangs looking at this contest. Another great all-around performance by the Mustangs here to start off the 2003 playoffs. Paramount on a big run on the right-hand side. That was number 20, Greg Crittenden. That was actually the biggest game for Paramount on the entire contest. Comes with 3 minutes left to go in the fourth quarter, and the Mustangs leading this contest by a huge margin. A little bit too late here as Paramount's pretty much kept their regulars out there, giving mostly their seniors one last chance to get any sort of points or getting the scorebooks here. And there's Crittenden again on the right-hand side this time. Breaks a couple more tackles. Finally brought down by number 24, Nick Woodward. At about the 15-yard line, it's going to bring up a first down and 10 situation for Paramount. However, only 2 minutes and 15 seconds remain in this contest, as Crittenden gets another carry on the left-hand side this time. And again, it was number 24, Nick Woodward, joined this time by the Mustangs. Nick doing a great job all season long. Number 37, Tim Hymanson, another sophomore, combined with Nick on the tackle. But it brings up a second down and 4 situation here late in this game. First, we get a good glance at Kevin Kelly, who's been doing a great job all season long for the Mustangs, both offensively and defensively, getting a chance to rest up for next week's contest. And nice tackle out there. That was number 82, Ian Wadler, the 6'2 sophomore. Again, we're seeing almost all sophomores out on the field for the Mustangs. Mustangs come up with a big tackle there. Nice running attempt up the middle, not going anywhere. That was number 71, Andy Oldfield. As well, again, number 37, Tim Hymanson, the 5'6 sophomore, coming up with another playoff defense, taking advantage of this opportunity for playoff experience. 2-yard gain on the play. 40 seconds left to go, and Paramount has taken a timeout. It's going to be third down and about one as we get a good glimpse at Ray Lee. Ray, one of the great defensive coaches on the Mustangs. Hey, Jeremy, speaking of great coaches for the Mustangs, this playoff picture reminds you of, maybe 1990, when the head coach for the Mustangs was, who was that again?
Well, Chris, that was, of course, Larry Petrel, who guided the Mustangs into the playoffs, his first and only 2 seasons at the helm of the Mustangs. And before then, the Mustangs did not have a win in the playoffs before the Petrol era, which has enabled this team the foundation for the success, which was built upon, of course, by Don Mora and his staff, led by, of course, on defense, Ray Lee, and the fantastic job Coach Mora has done offensively.
Of course, Larry Petrel, not only the man who got the momentum going for the Mustangs, but as the Mustangs recover a fumble on defense, as was Andy Oldfield there with the fumble recovery. Nice job, Mustangs will take over on the, that was the 2-point conversion attempt. But of course, Coach Petrel also came up, I believe, with the step up logo. The logo, the slogan used by the Mustangs. Since then, of course, he was a big pusher for the weight room the separate weight room facility on Maricosta's campus and had the word step up painted into that, that workout room. And that step up logo is still used by this Mustang squad. As we see the petrol tradition beginning in the late 80s and early 90s continued throughout today. Paramount now on the kickoff, taken by number 5, Bruce Robinson on the kick return. Bruce with a couple nice moves, still on his feet, finally hammered down, but after a beautiful 32-yard return, great job by Bruce. On the return, only 30 seconds remain in this contest. 49-6 is the score. Mustangs with this game well in hand. Jeremy, what did you think about tonight's contest?
Another great job by the Mustangs defense and offense and special teams controlling the game. One final note on Larry Petrol, he was at defense. He was a defensive standout at USC. And again, I'd like to wish the Trojans luck as they face off against Boston.
And that's the contest. Your Mustangs won 49-6 here. Division II first round playoffs. Congratulations, Maricosta Mustangs, on your first round victory. Again, I'd also like to congratulate the Mustangs who really came up big. Guys who had combined, specifically number 15, Anthony Espinoza, and number 88, Brian Jackson, combined for one touch on all season, came up with 4 tonight. Great job all around by the Mustangs. I'm Chris Lee signing off with Jeremy Sadowski, and we'll see you next week.